Hi students, welcome back. Now we are going to discuss some more problems on the exercise number 1, fundamental principle of counting. If an event can happen in m ways, following it, another event can occur in n ways, then the total number of ways is equal to m into n. Here, given four flags of different colors, we have to form some signals using two at a time. That is four flags of different colors. How many different signals can be generated if a signal requires the use of two flags, one below the other, that is upper and lower. One flag here and another is here. One upper and lower places are to be filled using the four flags. That is, we have to fill two places, one below the other, using four flags of different colors. Upper place can be filled using the four flags. That is, there are four flags of different colors. If it is green, blue, white and yellow, if there are four flags, we have to fill the upper place using one of these four colors. This can be done in, we know that it can be done in four ways. And the lower place can be filled in, if green is used here, then there will be only remaining three color flags. Then the lower place can be filled using the three flags remaining. That it can be done in three ways. Then the total number of ways is equal to 4 into 3, 12 ways. Clear? Next question number 5. How many two-digit even numbers can be formed from the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? Here given that 5 digits are given, we have to form two-digit even numbers, that is tens place and ones place, we have to fill using the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If the digits can be repeated, that is, if we are using here 5, here also we can use 5, then 55, 11, 22, 33, 44 are allowed. Okay, repetition is allowed here. Then, using the digits 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we have to fill the two places. That is, we have to form a two-digit even number to fill the two places. First, since the two-digit number is an even number, then the ones place can be filled using the digits 2 and 4. That is, the number ending with 2, 4, 6, 8 and 0 will be an even number. We all know that. Okay. Then the number, two-digit number will end in the digit 2 or 4. That is, one place will be one of these two digits. This can be done in two ways. That is, so the unit place must be filled using the digits 2 and 4. This can be done in two ways. Now we have to fill the tens place. Remaining there are 4 digits, but here repetition is allowed. Then we can use the digit which we have used in the ones place. Then the tens place can be filled using the 5 digits, including the digits which we have used in the ones place. Okay, then the tens place can be filled in 5 ways. That is, 5 digits, there are 5 digits, then the tens place is can be filled in 5 ways. Total number of two-digit even number is 2 into 5, can be filled in 10 ways. Clear? You can do some problems based on this fundamental principle of counting. Now, we shall move to the second exercise, that is factorial. Okay. Factorial. Exercise number 2 is factorial. The continued product of first n natural number is called n factorial, and it is denoted by n factorial. There is like this, n factorial. N factorial is the product of first n natural number. That is, n factorial equal to 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into etc. n minus 2, n minus 1 up to n. In reverse order, n, n minus 1, n minus 2 etc. up to 1. This n factorial equal to n into, we can write n this thing, that is 1 to n minus 1, we can write n minus 1 factorial. Or n into n minus 1 into remaining from n minus 2 to 1, we can write n minus 2 factorial. Or n into n minus 1 to n minus 2, etc. That is n minus 3 factorial. That means 10 factorial is 10 into 9 into etc. That is 10 into 9 factorial. The same way, 9 factorial, we can write it as 9 into 8 factorial. 8 factorial is 8 into 7 factorial. That is, n factorial is equal to n into n minus 1 factorial. That means 100 factorial, we can write 100 factorial as 100 into 99 factorial. That is, 99 factorial means up to 1, 2, 3, etc. up to 99. And including 100, that is known as 100 factorial. Okay. Then 2 factorial is equal to 2 into 1 factorial, 1 factorial equal to 1 into 0 factorial, we get 0 factorial as 1. Since 1 into 0 factorial is, you know that 1 into anything is that 0 factorial, and 1 factorial is known as 1, then 0 factorial equal to 1, we get 0 factorial is equal to 1. Okay. Next, we write the value of factorial, that is 0 factorial is, we know that it is 1, and 1 factorial is equal to 1, 2 factorial is equal to 2 into 1, that is 1, 2 sir, 2. 3 factorial is 3 into 2 into 1. 3 2s are 6, 1s are 6. 4 factorial equal to 1 into 2 into 3 into 4, or 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. In any order it can be written. 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 is same as 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. That is 1 2s are 2, 3s are 6, 4s are 24. Next, 5 factorial is the product of first 5 natural numbers. That is 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5. We get 1 2s are 2, 3s are 6, 4s are 24 into 5 is 120. Next is 6 factorial. 6 factorial means 6 into 5 factorial. Or we can write 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. We know that 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 as 120. Then 6 into 120 is 720. The next is 7 factorial. 7 factorial is equal to 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, which is equal to 5040. The 6 factorial into 7. 6 factorial is 720. 720 into 7 is 5040. Next is 8 factorial. 8 factorial is equal to 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We know that 7 factorial is 5040. Into 8, we get 40,320. Next is 9 factorial. 9 factorial means 9 into 8 factorial, or 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. We get answer 362,800. That is 362,880. Finally, 10 factorial is equal to 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 into 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, which is equal to, we all know that 9 factorial is 362,880. Multiplying it by 10, we get 362,800. Okay. Okay, next we will discuss some problems based on factorial in our next module. Okay, thank you all.